Trojan Source affects source code. Attackers are using Squid Game to lure in victims. And watch out for this new spam campaign. All that coming up now on ThreatWire. Greetings, I am Shannon Morse, and this is ThreatWire for November 2nd, 2021. This is your weekly summary of the threats to our security, privacy, and internet freedom. A big thank you to Adam, Josh, Jass, Chris, Alyssa, Dealfate, Duplex Mismatch, Mitchell, Cape Diem, and Ron for joining this week on Patreon. Patreon.com/ThreatWire, as always, to keep the show ad-free. And with that, on to the news. Props to Joel over on Patreon for sending this story my way. Researchers at the University of Cambridge published a really interesting paper yesterday on November 1st, describing how attackers can hide malicious source code so that a human eye would see harmless code, but a compiler would still compile malicious data. The researchers have published this proof of concept for attacks in C, C++, JavaScript, Rust, Java, Go, Python, and C#. And they also noted it could probably work against most modern languages that they have not already tried as well. So how does this work? Well, according to Nicholas Boucher and Ross Anderson, the two researchers, this Trojan Source attack, quote, exploits subtleties in text encoding standards such as Unicode to produce source code whose tokens are logically encoded in a different order from the one in which they are displayed, leading to vulnerabilities that cannot be perceived directly by human code reviewers. So there are two CVEs for this issue. One is CVE 2021-42574, which affects the Unicode bidirectional algorithm through version 14.0. Unicode bidi algorithm determines which way text should be displayed for different languages, like left to right or right to left. So if code is written in more than one language, a computer can fix any conflicts by allowing an override that is different from the logical encoding. But this can also be used in attacks called RLOs, or right-to-left override techniques. This attack uses comments or strings, which are ignored by compilers since a compiler would throw up a syntax error if there was an odd bidi override character outside of those strings, but bidirectional override still works as a part of the code even if they're in comments or a string, so they can be secretly added into source code so that a compiler would still accept them. The other one is CVE 2021-42694, and that one affects the use of homoglyphs, which are similar-looking characters. An example is changing a capital O to a zero, or a capital I to a lowercase l, etc., etc. In this case, an attacker could use the bidi FLO attack alongside switching to homoglyphs to make it even harder for an attack to be flagged. So due to the severity of this issue, they did a coordinated disclosure with 19 different organizations who are releasing updates in their own compilers, their interpreters, code editors, and repos to patch the vulnerability. Unfortunately, though, not all organizations responded so swiftly. Some even dismissed the disclosure. There aren't any defenses against these kind of attacks, so it's a very real threat that supply chain attacks could occur using these techniques. The researchers have not found any proof of the exploit so far in the wild, and compiler and code editing apps are working on patches. At least 19 of them are. Just as Halloween hit, security research firm Proofpoint ID'd a threat group called TA575 as the actors behind new malware being used to spread the Drydex malware. And what is this group using? None other than Squid Game. Yes. They pretend to be from Netflix, and they send emails promising users early access to the next season of Squid Game, or they could be recruited as a part of the cast. The emails promise you can watch the season before anyone else, or you can get access to the new season with talent cast schedule. Sign up! In either case, the target would need to fill out an attached document, which is actually an Excel document with macros, and if they are enabled, they would download the Drydex banking Trojan in the background. That Trojan can steal data or download additional malware like ransomware onto the target machine. Proofpoint notes that they have been tracking TA-575 as affiliated with DryDex since late 2020, and they send thousands of emails to impact hundreds of organizations per campaign. They also use the Discord CDN to host and distribute DryDex as well. Now, Proofpoint did include several indicators of compromise for these attacks on their blog post, which I have linked. Kaspersky also found several dozen malicious files scattered across the web that use Squid Game to lure in unsuspecting targets with themed scams and malware. A lot of these are malicious Trojan downloaders that install malware. So one would show an animated version of the first game while a Trojan was downloaded that could steal browser data, for example. They've also seen digital versions of the games online that promise cryptocurrency prizes, but in actuality, when a user signs up to play, they hand over personal data that could result in identity theft or malware infections. Kaspersky recommends looking for misspelled words, double-checking URLs, and checking for HTTPS connections. And if you're looking to download a video, don't download one that ends in .exe, .pkg, .dmg, or .msi. It's probably malware. I love it when y'all send me these adorable pictures of your fur babies. They are so cute. So these are a few from my Hush Puppy Patreon Alliance members. You can always support this content and keep it ad-free for as little as $2 per month. And you get a slew of perks at the same time. Each Alliance member gets over 10 different perks as soon as you sign up at patreon.com/threatwire. And with that, onto the third news story. So Cisco Talos is warning about a new malware loader that is being used via spam campaigns to drop malware onto infected machines. It is called Squirrel Waffle, and it's a new tool that was discovered and is being used as a replacement to Emotet after the Emotet botnet was disrupted in January of this year. Now, what Squirrel Waffle does is dependent on the attackers and what they want to do. They could be used to infect a system with malware like Quackbot, or used to infect a system with Cobalt Strike, which is a penetration testing tool that's been abused for use in attacks in recent years. Cisco Talos believes this new threat will be around for quite some time, so organizations, you should be aware. This first appeared in September, and it uses stolen reply chain email campaigns in English, along with portions in French, German, Dutch, and Polish to spread. The email includes a link to a malicious zip file, which includes a malicious doc or XLS file. If opened, those contain code that drops the malware onto the target computer. The attackers have been known to use DocuSign to get recipients to enable macros in MS Office. A script is executed and Squirrel Waffle is sent to the target machine from a site hosted by the attackers as a DLL file. Then the malware is deployed. Now, Squirrel Waffle is not detected as it includes an IP block list for security research firms along with anti-bot scripts as well. Cisco Talos included some indicators of compromise in their report, one of which is the domains being used for the malware campaigns. The other is a list of SHA-256 hashes for files associated with the malware. They recommend companies employ comprehensive defense in-depth security controls to prevent, detect, and respond to Squirrel Waffle accordingly. Now this week over on my channel, which is youtube.com/Shannon Morse, I'm going to be checking out the Pixel 6 as well as the Pixel 6 Pro. I'm super excited about both of them. Check out my channel for that video. Do not forget to like and subscribe to this channel as well. I'm Shannon Morse, and I'll see you on the internet.